Gurgaon is a highly unsustainable, untenable kind of city development. This is one city which had no master plan. The importance of Gurgaon was because it is next to South Delhi and also the airport. So we made a study and found out because of the two major factors, extreme acute shortage of water, underground water or whatever water, and rainfall also is very small, only about 600 mm, and also no natural drainage. Just 15-20 mm Gurgaon flood. Imagine if Gurgaon had that 100 mm. I mean, the whole city would have been floating. You know, that would, what you see now, it's called high-rise, high-density. So we have decided that Gurgaon can have only low-rise, low-density development. So we had decided that let's not have any large industries here. So we said Gurgaon will only have electronic industries, which will be non-polluting, non-water consuming, and comparatively small. Then 1991 we had the liberalization. So foreign companies, FDI, everything FDA, 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 and lot of foreign companies came. For them, the cost here was nothing. So there was a massive boom. And based on that boom, politicians came in, brokers came in, real estate dealers came in, lot of cash. Real estate business, as you know, is 60% cash. Lot of cash went around, and town planning norms were just not adhered to at all.
So there is a proper scientific analysis which is possible, where we analyze the total terrain of the city and see that when the natural rain will occur, where the water will flow. Is it being carried by the natural drain which is already existing? Is that drainage sufficient? Because over the years, when you keep on increasing the paved area, the volume of water for the same rainfall keeps on increasing as the pavement goes on higher and higher. Where that water will go? If it won't go anywhere by your design, then it will flood the area. Similarly, if we look at the solid waste management, if the solid waste is being dumped into these natural drains, which get blocked because of the solid waste being dumped, then again the flooding will occur.
So the distribution is also there, is whereas there is no, you know, stoppage, no restriction in terms of usage of water in the high-rise buildings and things like that. There is lot of, you know, restrictions on the use of water also for the poor community.
But there is a complete sense of denial of migration. There's a complete unwillingness to count migrants. You know, so if you are going to have 25 lakh people living in Gurgaon, but you're going to say that only 10 lakh live, then automatically you have a very fundamental problem where you are not going to be planning for 25 lakh people. You're not going to be planning for where is the water going to come from, where is the drinking water going to come from, when that water is consumed, the water that is wasted, where will the water go, where will it go?
तो इसके लिए एक तो ये है कि सबसे पहले तो जो प्रशासन है वो गंभीर नहीं है यहाँ जो होना चाहिए क्योंकि जो वेस्ट पानी हो रहा है उसके लिए कोई भी कंप्लेंट करते हैं तो उस पर कोई सुनवाई नहीं होती क्योंकि हम फील्ड में काम करते हैं तो ये हमारे अनुभव भी हैं दो दो महीने चार चार महीने तक लगातार बोलते रहो उसके बावजूद भी किसी तरह की कोई सुनवाई नहीं की पानी यहाँ वेस्ट बह रहा है इसकी लीकेज है यहाँ पर रोड धस रहा है तो इसको देखा जाए तो वो भी नहीं होता तो इस तरह से मतलब पहले जब रोड बनता है रोड बनने से पहले जो पानी का और जो सीवरेज की लाइन है उसको तरीके से डाला जाना चाहिए ताकि फिर वो समस्या बार बार ना आए
वी मेक सिस्टम्स बट वी डोंट फॉलो सिस्टम्स एंड द अदर मेजर इशू इज दैट देयर इज नो अकाउंटेबिलिटी
यस वी फॉरसॉ दिस वाटर क्राइसिस एंड वी आल्सो फॉरसॉ द ड्रेनेज प्रॉब्लम
व्हाट वी आर रिकमेंडिंग इज दैट द लोकेलिटी वाटर व्हिच इज नाउ going into the sewer lines, can it be taken to a nearby lawn by creating additional storage in the lawn, by depressing the present level to around by 1 feet. So that will generate a very huge volume of water. And this volume of water will be clean water. It'll be ultimately seeping into the ground and adding to the groundwater recharge.
Technically, every inch of road in Gurgaon, whether it's a village road or whether it's a sector road or whether it's a highway cutting through Gurgaon, must have rainwater harvesting along every inch of that road. And the minute you have that, you have two problems being solved automatically. A, there is a high density of roads in Gurgaon, and the more you tar the surfaces, the less there's percolation into the ground. So A, you'll have roads not breaking, because roads break when there's water logging. The other is you'll actually have groundwater levels going up. That can only happen when there is a very strict policy plan. It's in the master plan, it's in the law, that not a single road can be built without water harvesting drains running alongside.
Only to the extent of about 2-3% rainwater harvesting structures are effective and efficient at the moment. That is what the reports are showing. So given this particular situation, this area needs citizens' mobilization. We have sat together and come to know who all can help us also. Even the municipal commissioner finds this as very rewarding, because he also has promised. But at the same time, when we see the public consultation as it took place, the focus didn't come on water. So there's a lot of lip service till now on the issue of water and wastewater from people who matter here. But I think citizens will have to really bring pressure on officials as well as on various other agencies and so on, etc.